Hi, Woody Watcher, and welcome back to Championship Football on Football Manager. We lost our last game out a little unfortunately against Bristol City, but we do have new ownership, and we've got three new signings. So, with a game against struggling Rotherham up next, let's crack on and see if we can't secure safety at some point between now and the end of the season. So I say Rotherham United up next. They are in 20th. We do have plans in place to upgrade our training and our youth and our expand our stadium. So let's hope that things can go from good to better for Blyth Spartans. My goalkeeper on loan at Altrincham got sent off in the cup. That's not good. I'm sure that's not very popular. But we're on the TV away at Rotherham. Let's have a look. All the other games are finished. So a win would take us to 19 points, and we would stay in 11th place. Anything worse than a 3-0 defeat would drop us down in position. But more importantly, perhaps, a win would take us 11 points clear of relegation. Here goes. Okay, so as far as struggling, Mark Sanders is most appropriate person to play there. Ep0275, Da Riva, it's a recommendation there. And if we change this to a resistor, the most appropriate person to play there would be Rossida still, apparently. And we'll go with Callum Hume. Okay. Who's the most appropriate left back? Ogulumba. There we go. C is going to play up front. He's going to play it on the left. That's the side we're going with. Let's crack on. Actually, Cavallo can drop out. We might bring in Zanella. Squad numbers for these two. Let's get on with it. Oh. And get things underway at home. Right, Phillips gives it to Da Costa, inside to Hume. It's a good ball in, Ridley, it's the defender. Is it back? Sanders, wide of the post from the edge of the area, should have done better. Hume. Good ball in. Walcott, second of the season. Once again, Walcott rises above his marker. Score header. Look at that. It's a wonderful header. Keeper's nowhere near it. Do still have a jumping reach of 20 for the 6'4" centre back. To half time, a bit more balanced. A minute to half time, not really much going on that half. I think we might have to go two up front. We'll give it 10 minutes or so. The sea gets us underway. On Sunday, Brian. Nothing coming from that. Really not playing particularly well, nor is Wright Phillips. Hopefully the change of formation will benefit both of those. Yep, let's make that change now. So we'll go to two up front. C can be a advanced forward with Ridley becoming a poacher. There we go, we'll bring Wright Phillips in. Walcott to Costa can come off for Sanderson. And we'll make both of those available to attack. Is Ugolum playing well? Not particularly, so let's switch him out for Zanella. Who can have a go? There we go. Kind of waiting, Lindsay. Space on the edge of the area for Gomez. It's a good block. And Walcott brings it away. Oh! And Robertson has flattened him on halfway. It's going to be at least a yellow, but he doesn't even get that. Hume, free kick. Oh, side netting. 30 minutes to go. Phillips, free kick. Gives it right, Phillips, to see. Play the through ball, he finds Ridley. Ridley can't get the cross. And Dolly runs it away to Palmer. Well, back by Sanders. Into the ball, and Hume gives it to Zanella. A gumbo to Hume. Finds Wright Phillips down the right. Skins his man, no. And gets a block in. Here comes Palmer. Space on the left. Crosses. And Hume's finishes. Wow. Came from nowhere. Twenty minutes to go. Ridley's going to come off. For Broha. Minutes to go. Corner, Hume to take. Cummings. Palmer. Plays in Dolly. Scores. 2-1. What a disaster. final 10 minutes. Final couple of minutes, we go into 4 minutes of injury time. Can't believe we're going to come away with nothing from this. That's exactly what we're going to get. Sanders gives it away. Disgraceful result. Helps Rotherham out of precarious places. Disappointing collapse. Yep. Match press conference. New Zealand saying. No comment really. Learn from it, better learn from it. So hopefully we'll get a reaction here from Wright Phillips against Blackburn. Slight favourites. Could be in line. Touch and go. If I'm in the reputation of doing my job, so be it. Ogallumba appears not to be a great fit. Do you agree? Yep. Yep. Commenting on other teams. High ante team call, use team meeting. Okay, can you come back out for him? Volpe, can you come out for Capani, please? Let's go with that. Kick to Blackburn. We're by Walker, but not far into the area, Harris. pressing here, so that's good. Norris. Good challenge by Da Costa. Coming to press. Corner kick. Capani to take. See if he can't get on the end of it. Gumbo. Can get caught in possession. Nope. Uses it well. Gives it to Gumba. Exchange a couple of passes. Hume now to Sanders. Finds right. Phillips into C. Blocked by the defender. And a corner eventually conceded. Looks like it could be at another full stadium. Capani crosses. C tries to get on the end of it, but can't. And it's going for a throw. Patiently trying to build something. Da Costa needs to get a foot in on Scrab. He can't. Skinner forces a save. Results in a corner. And Scratch goes on to the cross. Capani with a corner. See? Does get on the end this time. And he gets his first for the club. 1-0. It's another assist for Capani. Defender jumps, misses it. C heads it in the near post. Quarter of the game gone. Letty and Nacho getting another one for Brighton. Luton struggling away from home, as are Swansea. Free kick, right, Phillips delivers. Walcott wins the header, of course, but puts it just wide of the post. Throw in. Right, Phillips. To Da Costa, inside to Hume, who crosses. Capani offside. Scrabble with a chance to cross. Corner conceded. Flicked by someone, and then someone rifled it off the bar. It might have been Butler or Yadeji. Half time. Fairly even, but we do lead 1-0. Da Costa. Inside the Sanders. Back to Walcott. Right, Phillips not having a great game. Da Riva, so we're going to take him off for both. And right, Phillips can make way for Broha. And it is a free kick to Costa to take. Crosses it and Broha off the bench, forces a save. And his first touch. What's going on there? It's behind. Gives the ball away to Broha. Can't capitalise. It's back with Ashby Hammond. Hume has it back to forward to Broha. looks at visit Sanders, who runs forward. Gives it back to Hume, who looks to distribute from the back. Plays it out wide to the left. Capone gets on the end of it. Skins his man and is fouled. Getting a yellow card, I would think, for his troubles. With a dangerous free kick for Capone to deliver. Red card. With a two-footed lunge, apparently. Minutes, there we go, and we'll bring on Ridley for C. As Sunderland equalises against Brentford. So C has managed to get off the mark in the league. 10 minutes to go. And we're down to 10 men as well now, with Da Costa getting injured. So we'll put both there. And that's that. Six minutes to full time. Four. Two. 5 minutes of injury time to add. Bove to Boha, back to Bove, tries to cross. He does. Capani back to Sanders. Out wide to Bove, chance to cross again. He does. Sanders on the edge of the area, blocked by the defender. Hume picks up the loose ball. That should be about full time. Oglumba has been absolutely flattened. And looks like he could be going off injured as well. Hopefully nothing too serious. Capani. So quick look here. Almost a foul out. Capani with a dangerous free kick. Crosses and it's away. That should be full time. Boha gets challenged, but 1-0, the game is over. Walcott with player of the match. Take 3 points. So we are now 11 points clear of relegation. Lots of teams between us. We are not even bottom of the top half at the moment. Brentford are behind, 2 points behind us. Things are looking good. Survival. Injury worry for Da Costa. He's out for 6 to 8 weeks. Who on earth is going to play right back? C ends goal drought. Yes, he does. That is good. It's a pretty bad one. Opportunity. Some of a fortress. There we go. Looks like Glow might have to play there. a tough game coming up next, Reading away, and I think that will finish off the month. It will do. And then another tough away game at Palace, difficult home game against Fulham, and then we've got Middlesbrough away, Luton at home, Huddersfield at home. So a bit of a mixed bag over the next six or seven games. But that's kind of what we expect in this division. Hopefully we can take a few points from them and solidify a mid-table position. And Rocky is back. Reading big favourites for the next game. Takeover rumours left, right and centre, Brighton and Cardiff, amongst those being rumoured at the minute. Palace losing 2-1 at home to Huddersfield in a potential six-pointer at the top of the table. But that is the end of the week and the end of the episode. Thank you so much for joining. Hope you enjoyed. A few more points on the board. Till next time, stay safe. Bye-bye.